It's time for the final match of the weekend here at the NEVSA Under-19s Championships 2016. It's the boys' final here on court number two. It's Sweden versus Denmark. And Louis Lett, this promises to end what's been a brilliant 3 days of competition in some style.
Yeah, the men's final, this Under-19s competition. Norway and Sweden making their way off. Sorry, just having some couple of technical issues. Sweden and Denmark come into this one after Norway squeezing a third against England just a while ago.
Yeah, so that's Denmark in your picture there, wearing black, and they would be absolutely delighted from their nation's point of view if they could make it two wins from two and be the double NEVSA Under-19 champions. Their girls did it just a few moments ago. Now can the boys replicate that? The two referees are being welcomed into the arena. The first referee is Dominic Bigailo. Second referee, Jon Alafur Valdemarsson. They'll be tasked with keeping an eye on what could be a frenetic final.
Danish boys really trying to follow in the footsteps of the girls, who put the dominant serving and blocking performance just a moment ago, beating Norway. The Swedish boys make their way on to this show court. Dan Gruvas, 16, number 9, libero Edvinsvard. Sweden are ready.
And who'd have known how excited a volleyball crowd would get about mini volleyballs? We've decided to give every single one of the starting sixes a mini ball to throw into the crowd as they're welcomed out onto court. And they're going mad for it. People clamoring to the front, getting to their feet. Good hands, my friend, on the front row. Really good atmosphere here at the National Volleyball Centre in Kettering for this final. The Danish girls, fresh from their victory over Norway in the final a few moments ago on court one, are very much courtside here to support their compatriots. The call from our MC, Dave Rogers, is let's play volleyball. This is going to be a great spectacle. The entire crowd, and there are quite a few of them just to the left of your picture as you're viewing it at the moment. The stand is full, the seating area is full, and the stand that faces court two has actually got people standing in the back of it, peering over. Lots on lots of interest in this boys' final, the Under-19s competition. Denmark are the defending champions. Denmark are perhaps fancied for a girls and boys 1-2, and it's Denmark who get us underway. But it's Sweden who get the first point on the board.
Danny Gruvas just getting his feet to the ball, swinging hard on the angle. It's quite a fast arm he's got in his locker.
Torstensson serving for Sweden. Denmark are very quickly off the mark too.
Nice play, playing fast behind. Just stretching the Swedish block. Big physical game this one.
A huge swing from Daniel Gruvas all the way out to that backcourt.
Vesk again. Quick feet, quick arm. Placement twice, he's cannoned that angle early on. He's going to get a lot of ball, I think, in this game.
Ace serve into the opposite corner. That's excellent, and it's a great start from Daniel Graveus. Do you want one of my point scoring stats, Louis?
He scored three. Two in offence, one off the...
I'm talking about in the semi-final. 19. Oh. 19 points scored by that man alone in the semi-final.
How did he score them?
Do you know what? It'd take me too long to tell you that. Sweden beat Norway 3-1 in the semi-final. I could tell you that for sure.
It's time. He unleashes again, Graveus, but... Just see it as a high toss. Timing slightly out, maybe just a little bit underneath the ball, meaning the trajectory of his arm goes, fires the ball upwards instead of forwards. Two missed serves in a row, Robert.
Don't start talking about service errors this early into it. If you were listening to the girls' final, we did discuss it. I won't say in some depth, but...
Nice serve.
It was mentioned.
Deep to five, picking on the overhand receive of Denmark.
Wide it goes, a bit overzealous from August Borna.
It opens up quite well in his chest area in that opening stage of the arm, but
Danish captain now, Nikolaj Hjort. Denmark wanted the decision for a second, didn't get it.
What we learn there is it's not the hardest of swings from the outside, but Borna does manage even at 70-80% into that last metre of court. It's good enough to win the point.
Good, tidy defence from Daniel Graveus and finished off by Borna. And that's a great pass by Graveus, because that came at him at some pace. Took all the sting out of it.
And gave his team every chance. That was the pass there.
You're a bit of a fan of this, Graveus. Do you want me to go and get a shirt signed for you?
He started very well.
Go and get some signed memorabilia for you to take home with you.
I want one of those mini balls that they were throwing out earlier.
Oh, OK. Do you want me to get him to sign one of those?
I'll ask him myself.
Super fan. Three in the block. That's what you see as it goes up to the next level. Try and get three in the block all the time. You find that there's not really one responsible for the tip when there's three in the block. They all just, the three defenders just react. Yeah, poor communication. Setter's trying to push up really early there, but unfortunately he's looking at his sixth man to take that ball, which is Graveus. Pointing the blame as well, which isn't ideal. Besevic. Nice start from Sweden. More jump serves this time from Borna. And still travelling. Just can hear a few car alarms go off after that one. They're going high risk from the service line, the Swedes. Toss is just a little bit on the inside. Keep that ball in the hitting arm. Oh, that packs a powerful punch from Denmark. Big, big service pressure from Oscar Kirsten Madsen. It's a big toss, and it's a big heavy arm jump serve. Here he goes again. Right-handed toss. Oh, off the chest, that's going to leave a stink. Some physicality out there. Madsen really going through that one nice. Might have to learn to sit back a little bit deeper in that passing unit. Madsen serve. Sweden will be happy to get off that rotation and into the technical.
Yeah, and into it, 1 point ahead, 8-7 the score at the first technical timeout. We said it'd be a fast start, didn't we? We said there'd be a lot of athleticism on show. And that's exactly how it's proved so far.
Yeah, both teams really going for their serves. Spinning from the baseline. Server brings an ace. It's Milberg who just, it's quite a low toss, but he still manages to contact it quite high, and it's a short contact on the ball. You can almost see that when you contact the ball, as soon as it, your hand contacts it, you almost want to pull it away to get the best possible contact. It's another good serve towards five, really trying to keep the opposite out of the play, I think, but no luck there as Madsen swings hard. See that potentially when the ball goes out to five, it's A, difficult for the setter to find the opposite, but the pass was so good from Denmark that it did open up all options. That was filthy from Mads Jensen. It's an overpass, it's a free gift. I don't think anybody in this whole arena would want to get in the way of that one.
Good middle attack for Sweden. Alexander Gustafsson was pretty much already up and ready and waiting in midair to pop that one straight back down. Good adjustment from Torstensson. It's the ball clipped off the top of the net from the serve. Well, anything Sweden can do, Denmark can respond to. Rasmus Mikkelsen.
Nice play, fairly easy in the pass, but it gives Danes a chance to really establish that middle. The opposition middle blocker. Now the Swede is going to really have to be on his toes. It's going to make him really commit to the middle. It's a good set out to the pin. That's really, really good work to get feet round the ball. That time he almost shows where he's going to set the ball, though. Besovic, but doesn't matter. Good work on the pipe. Previous set. Got round the ball so nicely to face out to the antenna out at four. Nice hands.
Smashed into the net by Graveus. 11 each and nothing to choose between these two so far. Big from the outside from Borna. He's the other big hitter in the Swedish side. Three of them, really, that they tend to rely on. Borna, Gustafsson and Graveus.
Sharp angle. He does. Both the outside players love approaching on a slight angle, getting their feet to the ball and really swinging through it. Bonus of being high from Denmark, but the call's given against them. Net touch. Potentially from maybe the setter.
It was Jensen that set it.
I think it was more the middleman, wasn't it? 14.
Yeah, Pettersson.
Just colliding with the net on the way down. It's a nice set. This one's a bit close to the net, though, so it'll be a bit of a battle.
It's a battle that's won by Denmark's number 7, Oscar Madsen.
13-12. Besovic with the serve. Again, that pass is in a good area from Denmark, isn't it? It's well tracked from the libero. Just gives the setter, Jensen, every option, and he chooses to go with the middleman, Pedersen. And as long as he keeps the ball out of six there, he's going to be quite successful. He draws that one towards one. And more big work in the block from Denmark. Pack a pretty big physical presence, the Danes. Especially through two, the setter's a big southpaw as well.
Grafeus attacking that one from deep. Denmark have got it back, but Sweden have another outlet. It's Borna on the opposite side. He's the man that finishes it off. Bounce right in front of Jensen.
Ball not quite in the hitting window, it's just on his left side, but his feet work so well and he is so physical, it doesn't really matter. He's just only going to count on the angle. He's not going to find the ball back to the line there, but actually it doesn't matter when you're playing at this pace and physicality. Nice swing. Interesting game this one, Robert. How are you feeling? Do you want to make a judgment for once, or do you want to keep sitting on the fence?
I'm going to carry on up on this fence, but I think the next point could be quite important.
Why?
Just because it takes you into the second technical timeout. One side's got to be winning when they get there, and the side that is winning when they get there is Denmark, 16-15.
Yeah, just psychological.
It is. It's only a small thing. It seems so small, and sometimes it doesn't have any effect, but you think you're effectively at the two-thirds mark of the set. If you're in front, albeit by a point, then you're on top, aren't you? Just.
Denmark have just been slightly trailing the whole way through this set, so they've just come good at the right time, really.
Reminder, you can let us know what you think of this afternoon's final match, the boys' final, hashtag U19NEVZA16. U19NEVZA16, hashtag to get involved on Twitter. I'll tell you what, there's a fairly large audience inside the National Volleyball Centre here in Kettering as well. Obviously the girls, representatives of both Sweden and Denmark, are interested spectators on the sidelines, but you can spot the England team on the front row as well. First point out of the second technical timeout also goes in favour of Denmark.
Just such a good jump serve. It's not really the amount of spin that he gets on it. It's the body weight going through the ball.
Timeout called
just
by Sweden.
Vicious contact.
We've only had 2 points since the technical timeout. So Sweden maybe just trying to disrupt a bit of rhythm.
Yeah, the problem is it's a very effective jump topspin serve, but it's not full of topspin, if that makes sense. It's a lot more comfortable to pass. It's almost such a heavy contact that it's not quite as strange, hard to explain, but it's not quite a topspin jump serve. So when it hits the platform, it's a lot faster, it's a lot heavier, so it's really hard to control. It more bounces off the arms than it does sit there and be able to pop straight up. Horrible.
Horrible to deal with.
No H. Horrible.
Oh, horrible.
It's horrible. It's a horrible jump serve.
Let's see if Oscar Madsen's got another one.
Oscar Madsen with his horrible jump serve.
Yeah, good this time from Svard.
See difference there, there's a bit more spin on that one, so it was always dropping. It wasn't quite that same punch.
Svard working hard again.
That's a great set.
Unable to execute the finishing touch, though, Sweden.
Did well there. Besovic under some pressure. He's always battling forward, so he has to try and get his feet behind the ball to be able to get a little bit of dictation on the ball. Fortunately, it's always just dropping inside. He has to get his feet a lot closer to the ball to be able to... Oh, more bombs from the baseline.
The Danish block is big and strong, and it's Mikkelsen's who gets the telling contact, and it's Denmark who are opening up a sizable advantage. Now it stands at 5 points, and they're just 5 points away from winning this first set.
It all stems from this serve. They're out of system all the time, Sweden, so it makes the blocker's job so much easier if they can't run the middle or they're having to set the ball long distances. So all of a sudden, if you're setting from a real long distance off the net, that distance equals time, so it gives time for the block to be able to get out and support the outside, the middleman.
Madsen will serve no longer, though, after that failed attempt.
I think the whole of Sweden have just...
Just rejoiced.
Yeah, big sigh of relief, even Zlatan, if you're watching, Zlatan.
When are you scoring your next goal? Fist to the ground for Alexander Gustafsson. Tried a almost Zlatan-like scissor kick, if you like, on his way down to ground. Couldn't keep that ball live. It's a fairly decent serve that Kjaer's got as well.
Better from Sweden. It's more power from the baseline, but really good adjustment with the feet from the libero. Good platform underneath the ball. It's held really well. The platform's held towards its target really well.
Torstensson on for Nielsen. Service substitution. Denmark again coming through the middle. After getting a bit of luck of it, the ball not catching one of the roof supports here, they then produce a handling error, Sweden.
Just double touch out of the hands. Really late with trying to get his feet around the ball, means left hand pushing through a bit quicker than the right. Nice set from slightly off the net. Besovic. It's good work from the sixth player, staying nice and deep, reading the game. And then he gets a chance to attack. Looking for a touch here, Sweden.
Not getting it. It was Borna, the Swedish number 11, that was attacking from deep. Just long, no touch. 2 points required for Denmark to take the first set. Good from Graveus, though.
I think they need to look after the angle a little bit more, Denmark, if they want to shut the outside down. Graveus, everything he's hit's gone across the court. It'll be interesting to see if they can change their block to maybe see if he can hit the line a little bit more. Sets too far in front for the opposite man. Denmark started strongly here.
They have. They may well have been inspired by their girls' performance. Well, whatever it is that's inspiring them, they've got a handful of set points here at 24-18.
Remember right the way, Sweden. Sweden were 16-15 up, 15-14 up. Really have dominated the last third of this set. Yeah, interesting to see if the outside boys from Sweden can hit the angle. He's underneath it. See, he's in too early.
So 25-18, Denmark take the first set.
Maybe rotates with the hip a little bit as he guides it down the line.
It was tight at the two technical timeouts. Sweden led at the first, 8-7, and looked like they were going to lead into the second as well. You asked me to make a rare prediction, Louis, and I said that the next point was key as to whoever took the lead into the second technical timeout. Did that prove correct? Yes, it did. I'm stopping there. That's 100% for me.
You don't try and predict stuff very often, but when you do, Bud, you're on point.
That's one from one, and I will not put myself out on a limb again.
Why not?
Based on what you've seen so far, have Denmark got enough to see this off in three sets? And have Sweden got enough to find a way back into it?
I'm going to say 3-0 Denmark.
Going out on a limb early.
Big statement. I think they're very, very strong in the block. And I think the main thing is whether Sweden can find a way to try and halt the service pressure of Denmark. I think at the moment that's a huge thorn in the side of Sweden is the service pressure from the Danes, especially Madsen. If they can contain that, then they've got half a chance, but
tough task for them. Well, when I spoke to Anne-Katrine Harkensen of the Danish girls team, the setter, after their victory a bit earlier on, she was extremely confident of a Denmark double. She said they are absolutely going to win it. Her and her teammates are in here watching. And I mean, she might have a slightly biased view. But if she says Denmark are absolutely going to win it, and Louis Lett says Denmark 3, Sweden 0, then who are we to disagree?
I think that all of those people who are listening to this who know me really well know that they should really listen to every word that I say and buy into every comment that I ever make.
Unless they've been on our Twitter, hashtag U19Nevza16, and seen that scribble of an attempt at... I think there's some trees.
Yep.
There's a couple of afros.
Yep.
That's pretty much all I can make. Oh, a stick man as well.
Yep.
Is that in the manual?
Two trees and two hairy cavemen playing defense.
Here we go then for the second set. Denmark 25-18 winners in the first set. Sweden will serve first. 13, Alexander Gustafsson. Sweden hitting from left to right as you view it in this second set. That's Tobias Kjær for Denmark.
Great setting. Way to spread the play from 2-4, but once again, there's a spiking error from Sweden. This is the two wingmen are not doing enough here. Too many errors. They both like hitting angle, and you can see now that there is that cross-court block on Swedish outsides, just taking away, I think, their favorite swing.
That goes Swedish captain Albin Bečević. Great play all around there. The reverse set, the tip, the pancake from the libero. But straight through goes Madsen for Denmark. Great work.
Swing. Great set that. Unbelievable set. It's pinged him quite quick at midlift. He just has to lift it with his platform, but that's a difficult task within itself, let alone to direct it right into the pathway of the opposite hitter on the 10 attack. 10 attacks, the backcourt attack from the right side. That was some effort, some ball control there.
Change for Sweden. Ulberg's on for Milberg. Augusta Borm now serving now for Sweden. 2-3. Service error, 2-4. Boom.
Big swing that. He's just drifted across his body a little bit, but what he's done well is he's managed to go fetch it from just the ball drifting over to his left side of his body and snap it back. He's almost seen the gap between the middle blocker and the four blocker.
Serve from Jesper Ullberg, dropped shorter than anticipated. Set was always going to be difficult for Nikolai Hürt to get over, reaching far and beyond what he was capable of.
Really underneath the ball, set just drifted off the net, but the approach, trying to play quite a quick game these days, especially to the shorter hitters. Can't afford to be in too early. Well left, a little bit confident from the libero.
Very hairy.
Might give him a little bit of a stare if he was one of my teams.
Play well so far, Pettersson, the Danish libero.
Yeah.
Kia hitting from the outside. It's been pretty good. They've used him fairly sparingly. Pettersson again, the libero, has done exceptionally well to keep that alive. Well, Denmark, I think, had half an eye on a handling error, but two advertising hoardings taken out there by Pettersson, determined to get to every single ball. Just see him at the beginning of this replay coming back into shot. Should have stayed out wide, Pettersson.
Don't know how Sanjib's going to feel about that, with some of the budget gone. Not going to be so happy about that one.
Well, that advertising holding came from Pound Stretcher, so.
Oh, nice. Counter attack. Like that a lot. Three balls, so.
Big reverse set, had to run all the way underneath it. And Madsen lapped it up. Another tight one as we approach the first technical timeout. There was only a point in it at this stage in the first set. There's only going to be a point in it at this stage in the second. But it's going to be Denmark who are 8-7 in front this time. Sweden last time. Again, just rescued a couple of points as we approach the technical timeout. And it's Denmark just on top. Good service from the captain, Hürt. Thank you. 1v1 at the net, won by Rasmus Nicholsons.
Really nice defense from Denmark. It's a little bit unlucky that that was the net, but good work holding still, arms out in front of the face.
Well, the Swedish team just parted there and allowed that serve from Pettersson to just drift between them all. There's a Swedish coach up here on the balcony with us who's just got his arms out wide in despair. Just about as wide as the gap.
Both take accountability. That's the main thing. They just have to fix it so it doesn't happen again. I mean, that's all.
Swedish timeout called.
It's understandable for Gruveus to want to leave that one alone because he wants to focus on hitting. Ideally, if he doesn't have to pass the ball there, he's not going to. He's going to allow his six man to, but I think he could have taken a bit more accountability himself. But
can't just take all the glory, can he? He's got to do his dog work.
Pass first.
So 3 points the difference. Denmark, the reigning champions. Denmark, the newly crowned girls champions. And we'll know within the next hour or two as to whether they will retain their title.
Too tight from the pass makes the setters. Vesevic's job really difficult, but more physicality through the pipe from Denmark. Just too consistent. Danish side. Really nice work from the setter again. He comes onto the left-hand side of the court. The blocker goes with him at the middle blocker before flipping it back and almost leaving that channel between the two blockers for the pipe hitter to go in between.
Denmark are just soaking up the pressure and then putting it back over when it counts. Taking some hits as well.
Sponging it. It's a really good finish in the block. Fingers and everything's facing back into court with the hands.
Big from Gruveus, but just too big. Nothing quite clicking for Sweden at the moment. Denmark thought that might have caught the line after flicking off the top of the net. You'll see here, and it just didn't.
It's quite a nice change-up serve, that, going for power, 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 and then taking a bit of pace off, looking for the sideline, trying to go across the body.
Good hands from Madsen. Doesn't always have to batter everything.
He's gone for the hammer. This time he's just changed his arm speed, taking pace off the ball. And the result of that is that the block timing slightly out because they're used to him hammering the ball and they have to go early in the block. As soon as you go early in the block and then the arm slows down, the timing of every movement's delayed. Very nice.
Good awareness of his surroundings for Borna to get out of the way of that because it wasn't too far long. He's a fairly big for a setter, isn't he, Jensen?
I mean, what you're looking for as a coach or in talent identification is a big guy that moves well and is ideally a left-hander. Left-hander can obviously take that ball and go on two, where a right-hander, it's really difficult to use your right hand to be able to do that. So look like they've got one for the future there, Denmark. He's got good foot speed, his hands are really, really good, but also he's got that left-handed weapon on him as well. Two missed serves in a row, though.
We're into the second technical timeout with Denmark on top once again. 5 points the difference now. They are firmly in control of this final, would you say, Louis, at the moment?
Yeah, the score says it all, really, doesn't it? I mean, I think they're just controlling the game in all areas. Sweden now struggling to stay in system. They're struggling to deal with the service pressure, but Denmark have just been ferocious. They're just strong in every area.
Yeah, they've been strong, powerful, agile, but they've also just thought about it when they've needed to. Changed things up a touch when required, but also stuck to what they know in the right sort of percentages. So it's a good all-round display so far from Denmark. Mads Jensen serving for them now, the left-handed setter, whom we were just talking. Sets for his skipper, Hewitt.
Not the quickest, not the tallest in this side, the outsider. But he's quick, he hits that quick set very nicely. A 5 point gain as we approach the business end of this second.
Out it goes for Madsen, and down it goes off the block.
Down line, it's a good serve as well. Wow, some set to find the middle from there. But unfortunately, it wasn't a good enough set that the middle could put the ball away. Very, very nice from Sweden to utilise the middle first time of asking. But the libero stepping in with a tremendous overhead set. Svard just jumping, his feet are well within regulation. And it's, nice thing from Graveus. So we've said before, Graveus loves hitting everything away from that shoulder on the angle.
The young serve forces the libero to retrieve it from deep.
Sets too low for the pipe, so second chance for Denmark. Out at two. That touch on the block.
Six points the difference now. Pettersson serving for Denmark.
Great passing. It's a real tough angle to find, to put the ball into the perfect spot. He did that well. Filthy. Get touch given against Denmark regardless.
You're not convinced by that one?
Yeah, it's a nice play. Nothing wrong with it. A little bit close to the net, potentially could be called for a dump, but questions being asked of Denmark. That's a fantastic set. See again, the play stacks to one side, so it means the middle blocker from Sweden has to commit to the block. Here you go, you see him go try and making two on the outside, but then he flips the ball back and leaves them one on one on the opposite side.
Good work.
It's a good set. It's a very, very good set to spread the play. See, quite a lot of the time the set is always working to try and leave his hitters with just one blocker on the outside. Does that, you know, he's done a good job. Relies on the pass, of course, as well, but.
When all those elements are in unison, it's pretty good to watch. Double touch the call from the referee. Sweden are hanging on in there in this second set. Timeout called by the Danish bench.
It's again, just that timeout that suggests that you're telling the opposition to sit down instead of letting them creep up on you a little bit. And then you feeling the pressure and you having to sit down is quite a psychological message that gets sent to a team when you call a timeout. Sometimes missed.
That's why we bring you in. The subtleties of it all.
I thought it was for the outrageously great banter. Obviously not.
The self-proclaimed outrageously good banter.
The guy who laughs at his own jokes.
I'm laughing too. Okay. Not always with you though.
I'm glad.
We've got to enjoy what we do, haven't we? Enjoying this match as well.
Vesevic just fires one down the line.
Safe to say that Denmark are enjoying it just that little bit more than Sweden at this moment
serve.
In time.
I mean, it's a tough serve, and he has to do a bit of DIY here, the outside man. Fourth, he has to take a step in, pass overhead, and then he has to chase out to get his approach. Does really well. That's why he's in the team. He's passing well, but he's also very effective in offense as well.
It's Borner on the opposite side for Sweden. Over the top of Pettersson. No mean feat, that. He's quite a tall lad.
Finish with his hands. Frederick Young. Should be a Danish point. That's very well watched in the block. Pettersson again. A lot of players would choose to stand down here, but two Danes in the block make a big wall.
He's in there with the captain, Hjort. Set point, Denmark.
One-way traffic.
Jensen just overdoes it. One set point save, but Sweden have got to save five more of them. They can only save the one. Denmark have doubled their advantage. 25-19, they take the second set. They're 2-0 up and seemingly well on their way to the 2016 championship.
Swedes look pretty low in their body language at the moment, don't they? They're pretty deflated and they look like a team who could pretty much already beaten. An interesting third set coming up.
Well, you had the bronze medal match, am I right, in the girls' competition earlier, where Sweden were two sets behind against Iceland. Came back to 2-2 and then lost it in the decider. You going to bet against that here?
Yep. Going to bet well against it at the moment. But that was a good game earlier. I mean, Sweden fought so, so hard, but then just lost their concentration in the final set. They worked their socks off to get back to 2-2, but unfortunately just couldn't get over the line.
If you are just with us this afternoon, firstly, where on earth have you been? But secondly, the girls' competition finished with Denmark as the winners, Norway runners-up, Iceland bronze medalists, Sweden fourth, England finished fifth after beating Faroe Islands in the fifth and sixth place playoff. All but two of the positions have been decided in the boys' competition as well after 3 days of action here at the National Volleyball Centre in Kettering. Norway, the bronze medalists, after beating England 3-1 in the third and fourth place playoff. So England fourth, Iceland fifth, and Faroe Islands sixth. All we've got to decide here is the top two positions in the boys' competition. That's all that's left to decide. We are on the way to deciding it. Denmark, who are 2-0 up. Sweden have got to find some kind of extra gear. They've got to find a way to get Graveus and Borner and Gustafsson swinging with a bit more freedom and a bit more meaning in this set. They've got nothing to lose now, being 2-0 down. So far, Denmark have done exceptionally well in the semi-final in which Sweden beat Norway 3-1. Graveus scored a magnificent 19 points. Gustafsson got 14 and Borner got 14. Huge scoring from those three, the like of which we haven't seen in this final. They've been stifled, they've been smothered by the Danish defence. Denmark, who are very much a bit more all-round. They don't rely particularly on one particular hitter. Hjort's been involved today. Kjær, Madsen, Mikkelsen, Pettersson, all been involved. Denmark serving then, 2-0 up. Kjær serves to start the third set. And it's Denmark off the mark first. Through the skipper, Hjort. As Louis said, not the tallest player on the court. It gives it everything and is very consistent indeed. Yeah, just dropping too short with the serve. Swedish skipper Albin Becevic show his side how it's done. It's the reach again of Mads Jensen, the setter. You see sometimes the setter will just try to go it alone if the opportunity arises, if a gap forms, if they can push it down rather than setting it for one of the hitters. But Jensen does that better than most because he's so tall. Can always reach all the way over the ball and get a much more substantial downward trajectory on it. This is the man that needs to come to the party a bit more for Sweden. He needs to force a way through if he's being stopped by Denmark. It's long from Graveus. Unable to step up at that moment. Oh.
saying this Danish team seemed to have strength. One of the England coaches sent field that they seem to have strength all over the court.
Is he trying to find a few with English grandparents? Sign him up.
Yeah, I think potentially that could be an option. Saying just the physicalities. But we agree that number eight, the captain, Niklas Horth, gives just a bit of stability, quick feet, quick arm, aggressive player. Middleman, Pedersen just, it's great middle, but that's also good work. Bit off the net, Pedersen again, just 3 metres or so away.
As soon as you name checked him, stepped up for you.
It's true. Sorry.
Swedish block in the way. And a net touch on the Danish side. Sweden keeping it tight, as they have done at the start of both the sets so far. Sweden not particularly pleased with that particular decision. They thought it got a touch on the way through. Referee Dominic Bigalo disagreed. Has that caught the back corner from Borna? It has. Borna buries it in the corner. 5-5. Torstensson. Service error though, hands the ball back into Danish possession. Now it's Oscar Madsen. Served really well in the first set. Good again. Madsen reeled off a run of several successive points on his last duty in service. He's got such a vicious movement on it. Another decision for the second referee. Valdemarsson to make.
Yeah, technical timeout again. Denmark are flying again, physicality in all areas, but where they lack a bit of physicality, they really bring stability through Niklas Horth. Big celebrations, they can sense it now, can't they? Pedersen has been incredible through the middle, but really the attack that they bring through position two with Madsen, and also the setter as well. They're just a force to be reckoned with. It's a really impressive side, this, for a young team. Robert, are you still sitting on the fence? Still got some splinters?
I think at this stage I might put a couple more of my eggs in the Danish basket than the Swedish one. That's as far as I'll go. Stranger things have happened.
I'm assuming you don't have a Bet365 account. other betting sources are available.
Not a gambling man. I lost $5 in Las Vegas once. That was bad enough for me.
Did you? I won $800. Am I allowed to share that?
You just did.
Time ball's just got caught going across the pipe attack. It means everything's being drawn towards that sideline, but it's well long.
Yeah.
runs the game very well. Besovic, not the biggest, but he's very good. That was really well found with the 10th attack. Second chance this time on two. No surprises, but what a bit of defence that is.
Yeah, excellent from Borna. Can Sweden make this count? Graveus is very much having the door slammed in his face once again.
Jensen is a 2000 athlete. It means he's only 16 years old, but he's a big, big unit, very smart. And again, you can see in the finish in the block that everything's facing back into court, fingers, hips, and it's a really nice finish. More service pressure coming up, I think, from Denmark. Bullets from the baseline. Confusion in the Swedish camp. Should be another Danish point, surely. Again, just a miscommunication, the 10 not knowing whether to run behind or in front. But this man, Madsen, not only packs a punch with his serve, but also in offense, is incredible. Takes off behind the line.
Timeout called by Sweden. They trail 6 points to 10 and by 0 sets to 2.
Do you reckon the topic of conversation is in the Swedish timeout, Robert?
It's a tough one because they have got such good attacking options when they can find them in the right areas and also when they can find a way through the Danish defence. Neither of which they've really been able to do in this final. And that's kind of 50-50, testament to Denmark's defence, but also Sweden just not quite clicking in the key moments.
Need a bit of grit.
They need someone to drag this game from the floor for them.
It's a nice pass, it's a good start outside. I think they really struggle to access the line when the ball goes out to four, Sweden. I think that's something that they need to be able to do a bit more of, as attack both ways, but they also have to stop that. This is insane stuff for the youngster. They attack so well through two, whether it's on the 10 attack or on the front court. Frustration for Graveus, who started this game well. He was effective within the first 10 points or so, but he's been shut out. They've been blocking angle, they've not been passing that well. And also, there's two big units out at position two to stop those wing spikers from Sweden. Uh-oh.
Free ball for Denmark. This time they didn't quite get it right. He'd have banked on them to convert that.
It's a little bit low, rare mistake from Jensen there in the middle. I think he wants it a little bit higher, Pedersen, sitting it down by his ear. So to be able to get the ball to go downwards is very difficult. It's always going to shoot off as it does out of court. There's two in the block from Sweden. Happy days for them. It's been rare that they've managed to do that all the time. They've got two again. But this time, this is just what is great about this Danish side. You've got Horth, who just brings this stability that we're talking about. This time, he slows down the arm, as we spoke about earlier. Means that the block timing's slightly out because he's so aggressive in his approach. So the block has to respect that. Go early in the block and take it. But when the arm slows down, takes the chip and out of play.
Just long from Mikkelsen's. Sweden, as they did in the second set, staying within 4 or 5 points, but just unable to close the gap any further. There's your man Jensen again.
He's been strong, huh?
Very good.
Good.
2-on-1 there, and he won it.
To me, he looks like he has all the makings of a very good setter. Height, good foot speed, good presence at the net. An absolute weapon of a left hand. quick feet from Pedersen, just can't quite get his left hand around the ball to steer it back in. Interesting to see the replay here. That's his right hand, but you can just see he doesn't quite finish and turn back into court. Sweden certainly do. Is there a last throw at the dice here from Sweden, maybe?
Yeah, Gustafsson and Borna certainly pumped with that one. It's Gustafsson that got the contact, but as you say, turned it back inside.
Some finish in the block, that, just to both hands. Right the way back in. Okay, good bit of work. Uh-oh.
All of a sudden, Sweden are firing a bit. Couple of big blocks, couple of big swings. Has that swung a bit of momentum?
I think their serving and their blocking's got better, and consequence of that is they're getting more opportunities, even if they're not scoring straight away. Again, good serving, passes out from Denmark. Another opportunity is a bit of a set drifts off, but some swing that from Nicholson's.
Timeout called by Denmark just to try and halt this mini run that Sweden are going on. Denmark still noses in front at 13-12. But Sweden, we said maybe 5-10 minutes ago, their body language was not fully dejected, but certainly didn't quite have as much bounce in it as it maybe did earlier on in this match. But all of a sudden, they've just got a bit more vocal. They've just looked a little bit more pumped up, if you like.
A few runs of points, a couple of big blocks, builds a bit of belief, doesn't it? And when you start getting that belief back, don't quite feel as dejected, and all of a sudden you've got a bit of hope. Uh-oh. But then all of a sudden you can see the body language of two, three Swedish players. One handling fault, hands go on the head. Negativity comes back in because they still realise that they've got such a tough task here.
Yeah, it wasn't that one, it was this one from Milberg.
Drops a bit low, the right hand pushes through a little bit more than the left hand.
Borna's hitting very well from opposite, though. Had a bit of joy out there in the last few points.
I think potentially, though, it'd be interesting. It's hard to see from here on this camera angle, but he's just hit the last three on that sort of same sharp angle across the court. So potentially there, you can see they're taking the line away from him, but actually his power's going on the angle. So potentially there could be a change in the block defense tactics to try and shut him down, take the angle and see if they can make a block on him, because the ball's not going far enough across his body for him to access line anyway. Oh, here we go.
Another big point for Sweden there, and it's great work from Edvin Svard, the libero. Just at the very start of that replay, a great pickup from him. That put Denmark under pressure. Sweden just finishing off points with a bit more ruthlessness.
It's a poor dig that from Horth. I've been his biggest fan throughout this, but sloppy off a free ball to become that complacent. Just not track the ball, not move your feet, and end up overpassing it.
Great leap from Borna again, but wide open for Denmark.
I don't get it. Don't get how he can hit that same shot four times in a row and nothing changes to be able to stop it and counteract it. They're still blocking the line. Everything he's hit has been from right to left on the angle. Change of block.
Denmark do manage to get the final point before the second technical timeout, and they lead just about 16-15. It's a tight one, and Sweden have shown flashes of the reason that they're in this final in patches. It's just about whether they can get themselves embarked on another run of points between now and the end of this set, because Denmark haven't become a bad team. But Sweden have just found a bit more joy, particularly with Borna hitting on the opposite side.
Yeah, he's on fire. He's maybe made the last 4 points from position two. That's extremely good stuff.
Denmark have led at every single technical timeout bar the first one of the first set. They're still just about in charge. And when they get the middle going again, it's hard to stop. Mikkelsen's this time.
There's Mikkelsen, sorry. Mikkelsen's through the middle. Just realised a couple of points guy called the Swedish opposite. Mikkelsen's master.
We'll let you off.
Take it happen.
Been a long day for you. Down the line, but just the wrong side of it. Sweden won't go away. Denmark can't get away from them.
Nice swing. 78% down the line, just a chip lets it come across the body a little bit and just helps it on its way. Nothing too crazy about it, but it doesn't always have to be hard to score.
It's the first time in a long time that Graveus has been able to connect from there.
Scores when he swings angle, doesn't he? Loves hitting the angle. They're not trying to take that away from him, goes through the pot this time. They are trying to give him the line at the start. They were taking the line from him, giving him the cross court, and he was taking full-on advantage, scoring points galore. As the game goes on, they've just changed to block his cross court, and they probably need to do that on the opposite player, on Borna as well. That's a good swing.
Yeah, good from Madsen. He served in excellent style, Madsen, but he's had his fair share of points in play as well. Milberg this time for Sweden. Straight through the middle. Good hang time. Something different with the reverse set, but Sweden saying no, thank you. They go in front at 19-18.
Huge time of the game as well. Well tracked, it's a good angle towards the target. It's gone for the sharpest of angles. Tried to hit that one off the shoulder. Fade it towards the sideline. The score.
Timeout called by Denmark. They trail 18 points to 20. Unfamiliar territory for them. They're used to being in front. There, Sweden have managed to just put themselves on top when it matters in this third set. And I guess it matters the most who's the first to get to 25, but Sweden are closer to that mark at the moment.
cycle this time. Well, Denmark, good blocking from Sweden. It's going to be right underneath the bus here, though. Again, the cover from Denmark is good enough to now have a swing. Wow, some play. Way to hang in there from Denmark before the ball's set out to Madsen, and he has been a constant threat, hasn't he? Just jumping from inside to out and then going straight down the seam. A couple of good plays in there from Sweden. They're a bit unlucky. Some outstanding cover and defense from the Danes have just kept them hanging in there.
Born has switched to the outside now, and he's getting a bit of joy there as well.
What you need to learn here for anyone really watching is that if he loves to hit cross court on the right side, his arm still functions the same way. So when he's on the left side, he's going to favour going down the line. Just haven't quite problem solved that one quick enough, Denmark, that you should probably block him down the line when he's at four. And when he's at two, probably stay on the angle and try and take him out. Need to come up with a
good little flick of the wrist from Madsen to get it over the top of the block. 20-21 the score. Jensen serving for Denmark. And serving well and serving Denmark level. It's all about who's got the nerve now. Denmark have got the winning line in sight. Sweden can see the comeback trail, but it's through the trees.
There's a few of them as well.
Denmark back in front.
Rare error from Borna. Again, that ball just doesn't get out wide enough to him. He's taking it just inside on his left side, and it means that ball's always going A on the angle, but B, it's well out of town.
Timeout called by Sweden because Denmark are just 3 points away from the 2016 championship. They're 3 points away from doing the double here at the National Volleyball Centre in Kettering. Their girls' side won the title just before this match with a really impressive 3-1 victory over Norway on court number one. The boys' side just 3 points away from replicating that here on court number two. Jensen serving. The noise you can hear is from the Danish girls' team. Full of high spirits after winning and here to try and support their team.
Absolute pressure out there for Sweden. Cannot afford to drop their guard. Three in the block. Successful stuff for Denmark. Takes them even closer. Again, every time they can get three in, they're going to. And when they're so out of system, Sweden, it makes it so easy. The more distance the ball has to go, the more time the block has to get structure and get three in.
Piotr, the captain, serving. Just
again,
two
should
more
be three
points
in the block. No block because it's a down ball. Free ball. This should really bring up match point for Denmark.
No touch on the way through. So no match point yet. And still no separating them. 23-23. August Borna, who has tried almost single-handedly at times to drag Sweden through this set.
Great pass from Levero. That's huge. Levero walks off very, very proud because it's a tough, tough pass. It's important when the ball hits the netband, you still have to wait a moment, see where it's going so you can track it, get your judgment, get underneath it. Does that super well. To be able to use the middle and utilise it so well on that play is really good stuff from Denmark.
Championship point for Denmark. And they've got it at the first time of asking, and they have done a deadly double Denmark are the boys and girls under-19s champions in the Nevsa region for 2016. It was an imperious, it was a dominant display, even when Sweden got up to their very highest level here in this third set. Denmark still had an answer.
There is quality all around the court, don't they, for a young side. From the setter, tall, left-hander, good feet and good hands. The opposite was very strong. Just consistent on the outside as well. Strength all around. It's a very exciting period for Denmark, really. It's been great to be able to broadcast to you from National Volleyball Centre in Kettering. We're just going to go down courtside for an interview with either a coach or a captain from the Danish team. But Denmark take the gold here at the under-19 Nevsa, and they've been strong, physical. They've run the ball wide, they've played fast, but they've also really, really played well under pressure and made some miraculous plays. We'll see you in just a moment down courtside for our interview.
Joined now by Denmark captain Nikolaj Hjort. Nikolaj, congratulations, you must be delighted.
Yeah, it's great. We've been working really hard for this, so it's amazing to get the victory finally.
And a fairly convincing victory as well, 3-0.
Yeah, it's been good. We haven't lost a set this tournament, so I think we did pretty well, and we're right winners, I think.
This competition was hosted in your country last year. It's come to England for the first time this year at the under-19s level. Have you enjoyed the last 3 days?
Yeah, I've enjoyed it a lot. I was here a couple of years before for the under-17s, and they've done really good this year, I think.
And finally, the girls' team managed to win their championship a bit earlier on. You've won as well. Big celebrations tonight?
Yeah, it's going to be fun. I think we've made sure that Denmark is the best volleyball place in Northern Europe.
Well, congratulations. Enjoy the celebration.
Thank you.
Matt Olaf Jungler, assistant Thank you. Anton Martin Riegel, Elian Ostas, Christian Jorgensen Root, Jon Andreas Poulsen Sethol, Severin Flosha Juego. The head coach is Nebosha Juric, assistant coach Benji Kavner Hus, and team manager Steven Jano Arsha. To make it into the boys' Super 7.
Thank you.